It's Monday, 17th September, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. With 15,000 police personnel providing security, over 2,500 idlers were immersed in Chennai and the suburban areas on Sunday. Barring minor skirmishes between those who took part in the procession, the event was conducted in a peaceful manner. Unlike last year, there were minimal traffic disruptions due to processions in the city. A large number of policemen were deployed at Tinagar and surrounding areas to ensure a peaceful procession. Huge Vinayaka idols in different hues were taken on bullock carts and lorries to Kamarajar Salai yesterday afternoon. Two crane operators who were dropping the huge idols in the sea said from morning till 7 p.m. they had immersed a total of 900 idols compared to 1700 last year. This was mainly due to guidelines and restrictions issued for the installing of idols. Political parties were not allowed to install idols, a senior police officer said. In a few months, the Chennai Metro Rail will expand share car and auto services to all stations. Chennai Metro Rail Limited has floated tenders. We're taking steps to ensure passengers have all options for last-mile connectivity and get affordable transport from stations, an official said. Each station will have either 2 to 3 share autos or share cars, depending on the number of people travelling through them. As there are not enough small buses, the CMRL began these services in select stations last month, covering a distance of 3 km in and around stations. A recent study found that autos were preferred over cars. While nearly 16,000 commuters took the autos, only about 2,600 used the cars. India will not lower its guard along the line of actual control with China, while maintaining border peace in sync with the Wuhan spirit, Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has said. Nearly a month after talks with her Chinese counterpart Wei Feng, Ms. Sitharaman said both sides recognize that the broad decisions arrived at the informal summit between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Chinese President Xi Jinping in Wuhan should govern management of the border. At the Wuhan summit in April, Mr. Modi and Mr. Xi resolved to open a new chapter in ties and directed their militaries to boost coordination along the nearly 3,500 km Sino-Indian border, months after the most serious military face-off in decades between the two nuclear-armed neighbors in Doklam triggered fears of war. Asked whether the decision of Mr. Modi and Mr. Xi at the summit to issue strategic guidelines to their militaries to maintain peace along the border is working, she said, "I want to believe it is working." At the same time, she added that as defense minister of the country, she was conscious of the fact that she would have to keep the border guards on alert. Officials who had dealt with loans given to Kingfisher Airlines owned by Vijay Mallya may be named as accused in a CBI charge sheet likely to be filed within a month, sources said. This will be the first charge sheet in the case pertaining to loans of over Rs 6,000 crore given to the airline by a consortium of 17 banks led by the State Bank of India, which alone had lent Rs 1,600 crore. Both serving and retired senior officials of the banks, including the State Bank of India, which had handled the Kingfisher Airlines loans, may be named as accused. The agency had gathered enough evidence against them on the misuse of official position, sources said. The top brass of erstwhile Kingfisher Airlines, including Mr. Mallya, its chief financial officer A. Raghunathan, and other former senior executives, would also be named as accused in the case, sources added. They said the agency was also looking into the role of the finance ministry officials who could have influenced the decision of the bankers. In the 5 months since 13 school children were killed in April when a train rammed into a school van at an unmanned railway crossing near Kushinagar in Uttar Pradesh, the Indian Railways has managed to either man or remove all level crossings in major routes across the country, thereby ridding itself of potential death traps for road users in its network. After the Kushinagar accident, which triggered a political uproar as it occurred during the Karnataka Assembly election campaign, Railway Minister Piyush Goyal and the Railway Board had advanced the deadline to eliminate all unmanned level crossings, either by banning or removal, by September this year. As per records, only 600 unmanned level crossings will be left by the end of this month. We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In China, petrol is sold for 85.15 rupees per litre and diesel for 77.94 rupees per litre. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 81.91 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.72 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 89.29 rupees per litre and diesel for 78.26 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 83.76 rupees per litre and diesel for 75.57 rupees per litre.